Hello friends, today I have brought a mathematics kit for you. This kit is for the students of upper primary stage. This box includes various items along with a manual for performing activities and playing games. I assure you, using this kit will definitely make learning of mathematics fun. So aren't you eager to see what is inside the box? So come on, let us open the kit box ourselves and observe all the items which are properly kept in their respective compartments. Observe the 6 plastic strips. Each plastic strip looks like this. Each strip has marking from 0 to 25. Can you notice any difference between the 6 strips? There are 4 strips of one kind and 2 strips of the other kind. But what is the difference? The difference lies between the slots created on the strips. 4 strips have smaller slots on them, whereas the other 2 strips have longer slots on them. These strips will be used in activities for angles, quadrilaterals and triangles. But how can we use these strips? These strips have to be connected together. How will we connect them? We have a small plastic box inside the kit. This small plastic box has various items in it. There are some screws in the box. These screws will be used to connect the strips together. Let us see how. We'll take any 2 strips and put them one over the other in such a manner so that the holes are one over the other. I slowly insert the screw inside the holes. The fly will be used to tighten over the screw like this. See, the strips are now connected and what do I get? I get an angle. These fly screws can be used in joining various strips. Another strip can be attached in the bottom and what figure do I get now? This is a triangular shape. Similarly, various triangles and quadrilaterals of different dimensions can be made using these strips and screw. Next in the box, there are 4 half protractors and 3 full protractors. But what are half protractors and full protractors? A half protractor is a normal protractor, which you usually use in the class. It has markings from 0 to 180 degree. Whereas a full protractor is a 360 degree protractor. It looks like this. It has markings from 0 to 360 degrees. So it can measure angles up to 360 degrees. These protractors will be useful in measuring angles for various activities. Next in the kit box, we have a small plastic board. This is known as a geo board. It has dimensions of 19 centimeters by 19 centimeters by 1 centimeters. Observe the surface of the geo board carefully. Can you notice it is made up of many holes? Each hole is at a distance of 1 centimeter from the other hole. Can you think the purpose of this geo board? This geo board will be useful to represent many planar shapes and also to find their approximate areas. How? Let us see. In this small box, we have small pins. These pins are known as dowels. These pins can be fixed in the geo board. This is the geo board. I will slowly fix this pin in the holes of the geo board. Can you see how the pin is fixed in the geo board? I will fix a few other pins on the geo board. I fix 2 more dowels in the holes given on the geo board. There are also a few rubber bands given in the small box. I am going to attach these rubber bands over these dowels. Observe what shape I get. I get a triangle. I can change this shape. Do you know how? I'll pick up another dowel and I'm going to fix it on the geo board. And then I stretch this rubber band over the geo board. Now what shape do I get? I get a quadrilateral. You can also make many such shapes. Enjoy with the geo board. Another item in the kit box are these various paper cutouts. But these are not just ordinary paper cutouts. These are nets of solid shapes. like this is the net of a cube. This is the net of a cuboid. This is the net of a prism. There are many more such nets. What do we do with nets? We can fold these nets to form various solid shapes. We will see them later in the activities. Another set of cutouts are these blue cutouts. If I observe these cutouts carefully, I'll see these are cutouts of triangles, and quadrilaterals. You know the interesting thing about these cutouts? Whenever you join these cutouts, you will always get a parallelogram. How, you wonder? We'll see that later on in the activities. Similarly, these are cutouts of circles. Each circle is cut out into equal parts. These cutouts will be used for activities related to area of circles and fractions. Like this circle is cut out into two equal parts. This circle is cut out into three equal parts. Yet another circle is cut out into four equal parts. In the kit box, we have 6, 8, 12 and 16 cutouts of the circles. We'll explore them later on. Another interesting part in the kit box are these pink strips. But these are not just ordinary strips. These can be detached to form unit cubes. How many faces does a cube have? A cube has 6 faces. Observe the faces of the cube carefully. Can you see that there's a notch on one face and holes on the other 5 faces of the cube? Can you think of the purpose of these notches and holes? These notches and holes can be used to fix in the holes of the other cubes to form various solids. What solid do I get? I get a cuboid. I can join yet another cube to get some other solid. See, I got some other solid. You can also join so many cubes together to form various solids. We will use these cubes when we explore the volume and surface area of different solids. Another object in the kit box is this wooden stand. This is known as an abacus stand. Observe it carefully. There are 5 holes drilled in the stand. Each hole represents a different place value. Like this hole represents the ones place, also called as the units place. This hole represents the tens place. This hole represents the hundreds place. This abacus stand will be useful for representing various numbers. How, you would wonder? Let us see. There are 5 aluminium rods in the kit box. These aluminium rods can be fixed in the holes drilled on the stand. Once each rod is fixed in the stand, you get a complete abacus stand. There is a small pack of beads. These beads can be put in the rods to represent various numbers. We will study about this when we deal with the activities on abacus. In this small plastic box, we have a pack of counters. Observe the counters carefully. Can you see that each counter has red on one side and the blue on other side? These dual-faced counters will be used when we perform the activity on addition and subtraction of integers. If you remember, initially I told you that this kit box will be used to play games also. So let us come to that part of the kit. There is a pack of cards, and these cards are numbered from 1 to 100. Let us observe these cards carefully. Contains numbers from 100 to 1. We will use these cards to play an interesting game on the factors of numbers. We have another sheet which represents numbers from positive 104 to negative 104. You might have guessed it by now that this sheet will be used to play an activity on operation of integers. But how do we play a game without a dice and counters? In this small plastic box, we have 4 dice. There are 2 red dice and 2 blue dice. We also have 3 counters. These counters along with the dice together with the sheet will be used to play the game on operation of integers. I hope that by now you all are eager to explore the activities and play the fun-filled educational game.